Funny thought. I was thinking about my mom, and she died at like 67. So I have like 14 more years to go. And I'm wondering if this is the way it is, you know. Are we, like, you know, we talk about the age, you know, people keep saying they're living longer, but right now we're looking at the group that was in the war years, you know, I mean, born around the Great Depressions, and then Dandrian, and they're the ones right now that are, you know, kicking off. So you can't really say that we're the same group when we've had, like, so many things. When you look at, like, the nuclear testings that's happened all over the planet, and things like, you know, all of us being exposed to these volatiles, but more and more. I mean, there was a time when only certain people had certain jobs and were exposed to these fumes, and now it's almost like anybody, you know, you walk into whatever the paint store is, and you can get whatever there. But spray cans all over the place. Yikes. Anyway, I did notice on the steel wool, it's a very interesting product. It goes super fine all the way down to extra coarse, and they all have different plans for you. This one I have is super fine, 4.40s. So, and they say it's specific for smoothing lacquer, varnish, polyurethane, and buff wood surfaces, and keep a high luster to wax and oils. And then it says it cleans the precision tools. So it does a lot of things. And then down the extra coarse will clean engines. So it's got a lot of different types. I guess I got this confused because there's steel wool, and then there's the kind that you use in your sink that has a soap. This isn't that, you know. This is the real stuff. I can't believe I have it here. Yeah. If you get the fine, it'll clean your porcelain. Then there are probably all those funny little spots in your porcelain that gets, Anyway. So what was I even talking about? Oh, the 14 years. Oh my gosh. You know, is that really like my time limit? You know, my mom, her mom went, you know, in her 90s. My mom didn't make it to 70. You know, so what is my time? You know? Am I going to make it to 60? You know, so many women have already perished, you know, in their 30s or 40s. You know, am I just like a practical walking miracle for my date of birth to my time now, you know, that I'm alive? Am I a miracle? Women my age, this Generation X group, looking at their steel wool, is it just unusual? Yeah. So yeah, I don't know. So, because I said that being the cancer, you know, gets quite a bit of women, you know. It's gotten many women that I know of. You know. Some related. Some very related. But oddly, back to my grandma, a strong woman, you know, raised off the Pilgrim Mountains spinach for many years, and just lived a hard life, you know, her whole childhood as a pilgrim. Well, she made it till 96, and the thing that killed her in the end was this infection, a urinary tract infection that goes through the body. You know, if you get it and you don't get rid of it, I mean, I'm talking cranberry juice quick, But if you don't get rid of it, it ends up just throughout your whole system and gives you cancer. So yeah, you gotta watch that urinary tract thing. I know, with her, it traveled into her lungs. It went and created a lung infection. And then the doctor put in a big needle in her bag to drain out the fluid. And it was the worst thing ever. It was the most painful for her. And she just lost all faith in doctors after that. When they put that needle through and punctured her lung, and it just kicked the socks all out of her, you know. So she did not do well after that. I think that was like her last year after that puncture of the lung. So yeah. Oh my God, I still can't believe they took her in at her age to even see the doctor, you know. At some point, it's just like, I don't know, it's too dangerous. It's too dangerous for them to go to dentists. It's too dangerous for them to go to doctors. It's too dangerous. I can't advocate it at all. Because it just seems to be like the kicker. Like, you go there and you'll end up with a quicker out. It's like my mom, she was dying. Then they gave her hysterectomy. You know, that'll get rid of all of that bleeding. Just give you a hysterectomy. That didn't help. It just made the cancer travel to the spine, etc. So wrong way to go. The wrong way to go. Start operating on that, you know, the last minute people. And that's what they do. So anyway, so here I'm at, I got maybe 14 years left. It's like, woo. And I was looking at my hyperfatigue, because I have like a major fatigue. If I lift things, I can't lift at all. Like the concrete, the smaller, I have to build up a bunch of energy. I have to eat a lot of food, and it's very exhausting to do. And I never was like this before. And so I'm like, well, I guess it's this door or something. Some capacity is gone on me. The key isn't turning on any longer. You know, there's only so much I can carry, only so much I can lift, and that's heart related. And so anyway, so I'm like, well, anyway, maybe I get 14 more. Ay, ay, ay. No wonder. My husband ran away. He wanted 14 under. He didn't want 14 more. Yeah. He wanted some woman who had extra lives, like a cat. I guess so. I guess I was failing health. He did see me one time when I ate some of the really bitter. I was out foraging and I ate some really bitter leaves, and I got so sick. I was flat out on the ground, and I couldn't move. I was like really ill. And vomiting, all of this, and he hated it. He gave me he brought me a drink, but only because I begged. I mean, he just wanted me to already just kick off, because put a tug, he did not want to be a nurse. And some men just don't have bedside manner at all. And I realized that, well, gee, I guess I'm too old for you. I guess so. You know, maybe you just need a younger woman. But good luck, because she's never gonna be as fun as me. Never gonna be as smart and witty and as sarcastic and full of empowerment and everything. Manipulations. She will never be as full of it as I. And that's what he will miss if he's watching this right now. Anyway, I lost my passport to you, husband. It's been stolen, and I have to wait and get another one. So don't plan on dying or have anybody related die until I have my passport repaired. And then if I have to fly to Europe, I will. But right now I can't go. So don't die. Don't die yet. Okay. But I guess I'll be there if I have to. I will show up and I will... What? Oh my gosh. Clear out house. All of that garbage. I guess I'll do that for my husband. Ay, ay, ay. Because my gosh. Chances are he did not find a 14-year younger that compares to me, even with this spot on my head. So love you. Love you, Mr. Do you have a Mercedes? I have my white vinegar. Ay, ay, ay. 14 years. Dun, dun, dun.